Thanks for joining us on the first of what will hopefully be a series of stuff in bro science today. And today we're going to be covering the bro science of runoff pH. Before we get to that, let's just go over what is bro science. Well, it's science told through the lens of bros talking to bros, trying to get something through quickly. Does this sound familiar to you from online discussions?
Hey bro, my runoff pH is 5.4, what does that mean? Bro, it doesn't matter, does it? It's fine. Thanks, bro. But you gotta make sure that it doesn't go below 5.2. If it changes too much, you're screwed. Ah, thanks, bro, so it matters. No, it doesn't really matter, but you gotta watch it. Thanks, bro, you the best. Bro.
Alright, that was stupid, and I apologize. Anyway, let's move forward from it. So, when we're talking about this, what we got here is we got dirt. If you want to know the soil pH, it's actually not that tough. You just grab yourself a sample of soil, wet it with some reverse osmosis or distilled water till it's just barely moist enough for you to get a reading. Mix it up to get a slurry, and when you're done, you know your soil pH. What does this tell you? Well, it tells you generally where your soil is at in terms of how acidic or alkaline it is. And that's important. Plants can only absorb minerals in certain ranges of alkalinity or acidity, depending on the plant. This soil measurement isn't 100% accurate. What really matters is the pH at the tips of the roots. Where the roots touch, the pH there determines which minerals, which ionic compounds they're capable of absorbing in with the water they're taking in. We don't have nanobots that can reach in there and report back, so we do the best we can. Let's do a runoff test. So I'm just gonna water this soil with some tap water until a little bit comes out the bottom. And if we test the pH of that, it comes in at a little bit over what we were expecting. So what went in was roughly 7.1, 7.0 water. The soil was at 6.2, and now we're getting 6.5. Cool, that's pretty much exactly what we can expect. Awesome. So what can we tell from this? Well, here's the thing. If the runoff is highly acidic, like we're talking nowhere near what you're putting in, nowhere near where your fertilizers are, either up or below, you perhaps have a problem. Either this baby's out of calibration, or your plant's about to suffer some serious consequences, or has already started suffering them. If so, this is one factor you can look at. And if I went in here, took a reading, and it said, hey, 4.5, I'd know there's something in there that's making it way too acidic. If I take a soil pH reading at the top and it's fine, and I have to dig down low, I'll bet you I'll find it's really bad down there. So let's take a look at the next example. Here we have our soil. It's been wetted and has a very reasonable pH. Now we're going to add some fertilizer to it. This is a little bit concentrated just to get the job done. So when we take the measurement on this pH, we can see that it's now dropping 5.3. And we expect it to drop, because we've added fertilizer, and this fertilizer is acidic, as are most. So this is totally okay. Now, here's the problem. For the sake of testing, we made this fertilizer at about 3.5, just to sort of show anything. Now it's already at 5 point something, which is about what we'd want in hydroponics, and starting to get a little low for soil. If we keep adding it, our soil will continue to get more and more acidic, and that's because it's building up in the soil. So how is this useful? Well, keep track of it. If you're putting in a nutrient solution that should go in at 5.8 or 6.3 or whatnot, and the output stays close to that, you're fine. If your plant looks okay, you're fine. If it starts moving in ways you don't expect it to, that's when you can start taking a look at other factors. Sometimes bacteria gets into this stuff and starts eating away at the minerals, which makes it more alkaline. If you're running with coco-coir, which is the classic example of this, sometimes you fertilize it and not enough liquid actually goes through the pot. What ends up happening is you'll get a little bit of fertilizer that remains in the coir, and that lowers the pH. Every once in a while is not a big deal, but if you get too much, your pH runoff will start to go higher, and that's what you need to watch out for. In soil, the same thing happens. If you over-fertilize, well, after a while, only dandelions are going to grow in your soil. That's not good. Unless you're growing dandelion greens, in which case, you go, you monster. So what's the conclusion here? Runoff pH matters. If it's extreme in either direction, that's bad. You need to fix that immediately. Otherwise, what you're looking for is the trend. You're looking to see if it's going up or going down with your current feeding schedule. Your runoff should target to be as close to the input as possible, but if it varies by, 0.5 in any direction, you're going to be okay. The real way to tell if your soil is okay is to take the pH reading directly from the soil, but it has to be where the roots are actually picking it up. And because taking the pH of this throughout the body of the plant is kind of a pain in the butt, we take the pH readings on the runoff, which is very easy to get to. So I hope this clears things up and helps you out. If you have any comments, suggestions, or you know, want to tell me I suck, that's cool too. Leave them in the comments. And thank you very much. Appreciate it. Bros. Bruh. Bruh. All right, stop that. That's stupid.